So there's loads of people out there who want to try DJing, but they don't have a clue where to begin. They probably think you've got to spend loads of money. So I thought I'd make this really quick video, show you how to get the software and how to use it. It's just a complete crash course. It's not going to be very good or in depth. Okay, it's going to have very basic information. If you like it and find it useful, please share it. If you don't like it, then be a little YouTube bitch for all I care, because I know some people will enjoy it. Okay, so here we go. First of all, go to www.ehowtodj.com. www.ehowtodj.com. Click on this link here to download Virtual DJ. That'll take you to this site. Click on download. Once it's finished downloading, hopefully you'll see it in your browser here, so just click on that and install it to your computer. Once it's installed, open it up. You should be presented with this screen. Just ignore that, skip that, whatever. Browse to your music. Hopefully you know where it is. If not, you'll have to find out. And drag a song onto the deck and start playing it. This is the crossfader. It takes the volume from one deck to the other. So leave that on the left. Find your next song, drag it over onto the right deck. Now we need to match the BPM. This one's 109.38, this one's 115.06, so we're going to have to slow this one down by doing that. You might have to click on this button here to change the percentage difference of the song. The range of the pitch, 33% difference is way too high, so keep clicking on this until it's on 6%. Now you can do much more accurate corrections. So match the speed of the songs, as close as you can get it. Fortunately, this one's either 0.06 BPM slower or 0.06 BPM faster. So for the purpose of this video, we're going to cheat and press the sync button. That'll match them precisely. Now, when this song is near the end, we're going to start playing the other one. First of all, we need to check that the other one is at a suitable place of the song to start playing. So normally we would do this on the first beat of the song, so you would skip through the song like this and find the first beat. The beats are these high peaks here, and normally where the squares are below them. So you'd normally get close to that and then use the wheel, drag the wheel right to the beginning of the first beat, and press the cue button. Now whenever you press the cue button, the song will go back to that place. So we wait for an appropriate time in the song that's playing, and then we will start playing the new one. Okay, that'll probably work, so I'm going to go back to the song that's playing. That was just a demonstration, by the way. You would normally be doing this in your headphones to check that the songs are compatible. So take the volume, take the crossfader all the way across to the left again. I'm going to start playing this one at the end of this section. Listen to the music and get ready for when it changes. Now, so in another 32 beats, I'm going to start playing the new song. That's the end of 16. That's basically how to DJ in 5 minutes. You'll notice that I waited for an appropriate time in the currently playing song to start the new one. If you listen to this song now, you'll notice that everything happens in 32 beats, so wait for the end of this section. 1, 2, 3, 4. Start a new section here. So that's it really, go and listen to your music, listen for the appropriate time in the song to start playing the next one. A couple of things to mention that I forgot Just make sure that the songs are a close BPM to begin with. Anything over about 5 BPM difference, there's no point in trying to mix them. One of them will sound a bit weird if you're playing it too fast or too slow. So play similar music, like 2 house music tracks or 2 trance music tracks or whatever, and just have a listen to them and notice how something changes every 32 beats, and try and match the 32 beat section of the new song with the start of a 32 beat section of the currently playing song. If you do that, your mixes will sound fantastic and everybody will be amazed, okay? In future videos, I'll be teaching you how to beat match properly by ear. There'll be no using the sync button. I'll be teaching you a lot more advanced stuff about DJing in general. So head over to www.ehowtodj.com and look out for the other tutorials.